All right, this is sort of a continuation of the IVA tutorial, which turned out to be a little more expansive than I originally anticipated. But this is more of the actual IVA part. What I've got here is I've started, this is the IVA I built or put together in the previous videos, and you can see it's empty, there's nothing in here. But the interior is correctly aligned with the exterior and all that jazz. And now we're going to put instrumentation into this IVA. And let's see. So you gotta have your Unity, you have your part tools installed, and once you have your part tools installed, you get this panel here. You get this panel by clicking on Tools, KSP Part Tools. So first thing, when you open this up, you go to Setup, go to the Setup tab, Set Data Directory. You can set it to any directory you want. It loads it, everything inside of that directory just like the KSP loader. It reads any internal config files and any prop config files. And I'll show you what those config files look like in a few minutes. So I've got it pointed to the game data folder, so that means every single internal config file in here will get read. All of the stock pod internals I will have access to, all the B9 spaces I'll have access to. I don't have the full B9 package extracted, so I won't be pulling up any B9 stuff. But there you see the demo folder from the previous videos. And then for the it does the same for the prop files. So for example, I can pull up the props for the, well, this is just the setting the data directory. So I don't want to change that, but if I open up, here's the KSP folder. So as an example, here are the props for the transparent pods that I did. And just to open up one of these, here's a throttle. This is a throttle is a pretty simple prop to start with. So, they all follow the same convention. All cap letters at the top tells KSP what kind of config file this is. Prop for internal instrumentation and stuff that you might interact with. Internal is your container, is your basic IVA shell config that holds the modules for your internal seats, for your camera switch, and for all your prop position, orientation, and scale. So what happened is when you open up a space in Unity and then add your props to it and use part tools to write out the config file, all part tools does is write the individual props, position, rotation, and scale into the internal config file. So if I pull up an internal config file here in spaces, usually that's how they're arranged, it looks like this. Right, you got your modules. These are the internal seats. Every one of these internal seat modules will spawn a kernel. The how that works was covered in the last video, so I won't go over that. And then down here are all the props that you have in your IVA. So every prop block, prop, curly brackets, same thing. And all you have here, the name here is the same exact name that you gave the prop initially in the prop config file. So if I were to find this throttle again, so the prop name is throttle control, and then in the internal space internal config file, I could just search for this. If this was or is if this piece is placed in this IVA, I will be able to find it, and there it is. So, KSP Part Tools writes out the scale, rotation, position, and that's aligned to the I believe that's relative to the Unity scene space. So if you shift that prop up by 10 meters, then in game it's going to do the same thing, and it will become, for all practical purposes, invisible to your IVA because it's out of your field of view and you won't be able to interact with it. Alright, so you set your data directory, and then, you know, if you add or remove any props or internal config files, you want to hit refresh so it reloads all of the config files and populates your spaces and props list again. Spaces again, that's your internal. So I'm gonna pull up the empty IVA from the previous video. Here it is. And then you have your internal space script here. This is what will load and save all your IVA prop placements. So just for for the sake of brevity, I'm going to pull up the standard cockpit, which is the same exact setup as this, and then copy the internals over. So there's the standard cockpit setup. If I move this aside, so there's the one that was built in the demo. Here's the standard setup. And you can see the instruments are already placed in here. So all your internal props should be placed under your space object, right? You can see here this has the same internal space script. Space name is your internal script, the name that you gave to the config file, which we can see here. If we go spaces, and there we go. So that name is what the part tool loader will pull up right here. And then the directory, you can set this directory to write to a new internal if you're making variations. So you set this to a different folder, you write out to a whole new config. If you do that, you have to make sure your internal mesh and textures are linked properly, otherwise your internal won't compile at load time when KSP starts up. So I'm going to, and these pretty much work like standard Unity game objects. Each of them have a prop script. These are useful when you are placing them. But it depends on the prop's original setup. As you can see, the stock props are all set up such that the up direction is a Y. This is because the script allows you to quickly orient the prop to the surface that the negative Y is pointed at, right? So as an example, we can rotate this out of view, you know, into some odd orientation. And then if we hit orient down, you can see it's snapped to the surface on the back. And then you can use snap down, and that will move it down to the surface that it just oriented to. So if we wanted to place this indicator panel on the floor, and just move it over, orient down, snap down, it's on the floor. So, you know, if you start building internal props, that's something to keep in mind. Technically, the orientation doesn't matter because each prop's individual orientation is recorded as you place them, but building it this way with the Y as the up direction will make decorating the interior a little bit quicker, because you can use these scripts. I don't know if there is a, well, I believe the, no. Well, this one, so for example, if I, this one I built, right? You can see the Y direction is pointing in a different direction than you would expect. The Y direction should be pointing up and down, but this is pointing forwards and backwards. So if I were to use the snap orient down, it's gonna think it's lying down on its back, and it's gonna do that. So that's something to keep in mind if you start building internal props. So all of these are stock props, except this gun sight here, which also doubles as a simple compass. I'll do something to cover creating internal props in future. So if you I did this to make it easier for myself, because I had, I think, half a dozen IVAs that were created, and they're all pretty much standardized to this shape and size, so I could simply duplicate all these props, move them over to my other internal. I could get rid of this one now. So I can just group select these. Well, yeah. So, like as I said earlier, the prop orientation are recorded relative to the world space. So right now, what's gonna happen is if you write this out, well, it's relative to your IVA's pivot here. So if you write this out, all these props will be shifted to the left. I believe that's what will happen. So I'm going to save this. I believe all of these will be shifted to the left, and then the Kerbal is going to spawn here. And if you look to the left, you will see these in space. So I'm going to go and reload this and see if that's what will happen. Again, use the if you do a lot of modding, it's best to use the module manager reload function. As I noticed, if you use the stock Alt+F12 database reload, it skips module manager settings, so you end up with parts not loading or parts loading with settings that are incorrect. So let's go to IVA, and yep, there we go. So as you can see there, the props are spawned to the left of the IVA, which is what we have here. This is the 000 of the IVA in game, and the props locations are recorded relative to this point here. So let's fix that quickly. To do that, you can just move these out into world space, reset your prop, and you can see now everything's lined up. And then now you just move everything back into your IVA space. Save the config and go back, reload. Go back to our IVA. All the instruments should be in the correct place. And there we go. Now this works the same exact way for any mod parts, mod internals, for example, raster prop monitor. So just as a quick example, I'm going to, well, I don't have RPM installed, but I do have some, let's see, okay, I do have a custom prop that I could put in there as an example. So as an example of doing custom props, right, we're going to place a throttle I built, and we're going to replace it. We're going to replace the stock throttle with the custom one I built. Now, this is just for placement. I'm not talking about the ins and outs of actually building a functional throttle. This is just replacing stock internal parts, internal props, with custom props that you built or from other mods like RPM, right? So quick way of doing this, there's our RF throttle. Right, you want a unique prop name so it doesn't conflict with existing stuff. So if you named your custom throttle as well, set with the same capitalization, KSP is going to get confused and probably load the two meshes, two objects interchangeably, and depending on what it feels like at the time you load your internal, it might have one throttle or the other. So I'm going to move this one down, and I'm going to move this one so that it's right above it. That way we'll have a nice side by side. You can change the scale, rotation. Again, I'll cover functionality and setting up internal props in a different video. This is just for placement of props in the IVA. So that's all you need to do. Save the config, reload our database. What we should see is the throttle with a red handle on the left side, just above the stock throttle. And there it is. Now if you push either one, both of them will move because they're tied to the same variable in the game. Right, the throttle setting. Now, there are a lot of additional stuff you can do in the IVA, so... Now, okay, for example, right, if you want to add... The IVA is kind of dark, you can add a light, but you don't do that. Well, you can build a light prop, right, which is one way to do this. You can build a light prop, set up the internal config, and then place it into your IVA. The other way to do it is to bring up your old IVA prefab. I believe I saved the prefab. Apparently not. But that's okay. I have the scene file. So there's our IVA. Hide that, reset this position. So if we wanted to add a light in here, right, and then place it this way, it depends on which way you place it. If you place it towards the front, the kerbal's face is going to be lit, and you'll be able to see the difference in the portrait camera in the lower right. If you place it towards the back, then the Kerbal's face will be unlit by this light, but the instrumentation panels will be a little bit better. This is more of a creative decision depending on how your internal instruments are and how your IVA layout is. This varies. Now you want a low setting, low range on this because these lights don't cast shadow, so it will light everything around it. As it's not as important in the IVA because it's actually rendered in a separate scene than the rest of the world in KSP, so this won't light the external of the aircraft. But if you have something like a emissive light on your cockpit window from the outside and you place a light for that, you want to drop the range down so it doesn't light up the entire vessel. So for this should be about good. What we would expect to see is this is going to get brighter, and we should have some better lighting on the instruments themselves. And then the Kerbal's face is going to look like it's lit from below. And just to make it easier to see, I'm going to make this bright green. For internal lights, typically you want something lower than one. One will be pretty bright already. This is going to make the cockpit look glowing green, but this will make it easier to see the effect. So we write this out again, reload our database once this finishes. Okay, this is done. Reload our database. Now, with lights in the IVA, you don't want to overdo it. Usually, one is about all you want to have in there. I don't know if it's subject to the same number of light source settings in the KSP game settings. It may or may not be, I don't know. But, to be on the safe side, one per Kerbal is generally a good guide to follow. More than that, you could see frame rate drops. So our database is reloaded. Go back to our IVA. The portrait should be super green. And there it is. You can see the underlit from the light here, right? Because the light is below the Kerbal's face. We go into IVA, we got nice green glow. So, yeah, there you have it. Placing standard stock props works the same way as any custom mod props. So, if you got a mod that adds props, internal props, and they're in this game in the game data directory folder, and you have your part tools set to read that folder, right? Anything inside of this data directory will get populated here. If you let's see if I can spawn a Now, if something doesn't spawn in here, it's probably because the mesh is linked incorrectly. That usually happens if you, say, copy and paste some internal files out of KSP game data into a different folder, and then you set your data directory to that new folder. What you'll have is it will still read all the config files and populate your spaces and props tabs, but the config files themselves won't be able to find the necessary files to to load the models, just like in KSP, and so it won't spawn in here. And you'll get a red text error in here saying texture not found or mesh model is not found for a particular prop or internal. So the safest way to do it is just point directly to your game folder, but only work with the spaces that you created and not change any of the stock spaces. All right, if you do decide to change the stock spaces for your, you know, for your own whatever, be sure to save the new internal config file to a different location so it doesn't overwrite the stock space. Right, so, you know, here's the generic internal space. No, nothing in here, huh? Interesting. I thought there would be instrumentations in here. But, now we can look at the lander cabin. Right, usually the more props that's in the space, the longer it takes to load. So here's the stock lander cabin. And, you know, you can rearrange the stuff, save out your config, and then in your game, the lander cabin will have the new arrangement. You know, assuming you saved over the original internal config file. So if you do that, it's a good idea to back up your original config file somewhere. As long as the models all stay in the same location, you can copy the config file out somewhere as a backup, modify it. If you want to restore it, just copy the old original config file, internal config file, back into the spaces folder. So, quick recap, right? Dealing with internals, you have your spaces, and you have your props. All your space config files starts with internal, and then curly bracket and name equals, right? That tells the game and part tools what to load, right? So for example, this is for a different cockpit, a two-seater. You can see tell because it has two internal seat modules and they're named differently so they don't conflict. And then model node, right? The model node works in props, internal, and part config files. So that makes this extremely useful. You can share textures between props, internals, and externals. So for example here, these two textures are shared across all of the IVAs, some of the props, and probably 80% of the part pieces I have in the Retro Future pack. I mean, the reason that I do this is because texture is the most memory intensive thing to do in KSP. Usually when you have a lot of mods installed and you run into and the game crashes because you ran out of memory, the most likely case is because there are too many textures and it's eating up all your RAM. So anyway, that's a digression. So back to this, right? Your internal curly bracket name, same setup as your part configs. And for your prop configs, again, same thing. Prop, curly bracket, name, model, and then some internal modules. Best to start with the stock stuff to get a feel of how they work. One thing to note is internal modules do not work in part configs, and part modules will not work in prop configs. So if you try to put module animate generic in here, it's not going to work, because that's a part module and this is a prop module. Let's see. And then props, right? Prop config gets read by part tools and populates here. So if you want to add a prop here, for example, let's see what. Right, okay. Yeah. So, you know, I could add. So if I wanted to add that red hand throttle with the red handle in here, I'll just find it in here. It was called RF throttle. There we go. Drop it in. Another thing to note is that everything will be childed directly to our internal space object, right? Whenever you write to the config, or whenever you reload. While you are arranging these things, it's useful to use this trick to move things, to snap things to where, to the general location where you want them for, you know. So in that last example there, I created a new throttle and I wanted to place it at the same location as the original throttle. I child it to the original throttle, reset my transform, because this is relative to the parent object. And now it's in the same general location, right? And then I can set my scale to what I want, move this back out to the child of the internal space, and then I could remove the original throttle, and now we have the new throttle in place of the old one. And this one should work with the snap down scripts, right? Orient down, good, snap down. Now the, I had built it backwards, so fortunately I'm gonna have to rotate this, right? So now if I save this config file and load up this part in KSP, I'm not gonna run through that because it takes a little time, but save this config file and then open up the small lander can. This prop should be in the IVA in place of the original prop. Now if you want to undo your changes, you can just hit reload. As long as you didn't save over the config file. See, now you can see the original throttle prop has popped back into place. And clear props does exactly that. It will get rid of all your props in the internal space, and you can start populating this from scratch. So I believe that covers everything regarding decorating your internal space. B9 does the same exact thing. There's a lot of custom props there. RPM does the same thing. What RPM does is it has a separate internal space created with the RPM props, and then a module manager replaces the internal space. Right, so as I covered in the last, or in the previous video, the internal is set in this section here, the internal curly bracket name. Right, so if we were to change this part to use a different internal, you do that by changing this name. So RPM uses a module manager config to change this internal to a RPM specific internal at load time. You know, but it, module manager will detect whether you have RPM installed, and then it changes the internal. The old internal still exists. If you uninstalled the RPM mod, Module Manager will automatically switch the internal back to the original. All right, so yeah, any questions, feel free to post on the forums. And I will do a video on actually making internal props later. So, yeah, thanks for watching.